Well, you may not think about this with everything else you've got going on right now, but it's important to maintain a healthy brain, especially during the pandemic.
Earlier today, we talked with Dr. Nathaniel Chin, the medical director of Wisconsin's Alzheimer's Disease Research Center, about a keynote speech that he's giving tomorrow about ways that you can keep your brain in top shape.
Well, the pandemic has really disrupted a lot of routines. So people who are used to living a healthy lifestyle now have to find different ways of doing that. It's also led to isolation and a lot of psychological symptoms of depression, anxiety, and anger. So not only are we having to deal with our physical health, we're having to deal with our mental health in a completely different way.
What are some of your top tips, some of your best advice for things we should all be doing right now?
Well, I think the benefit of a healthy lifestyle is that each behavior feeds into other behaviors. So I often ask my patients and community members to start by being physically active. The most science is backed by that. And so people walking is a really good thing, or if you're in your home, chair exercises. But that tends to lead to things like improved sleep and being more mindful of the foods that we eat. And then staying active as far as keeping your brain active. So puzzles, games, things like that.
A lot of people are stress eating. That's a big problem.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, and I'm guilty of that as well. And late night eating, because our routines are different. And so one of the things I would say is acknowledging your stress is really important. We're all going through a very difficult time, and for different reasons. And to not fight some of those urges to have food. Frankly, the resistance we put against eating certain foods might be more detrimental to us than just eating that food. Mm-hmm. And I would encourage people to simply be mindful of that. Perhaps it's okay to have that cake or that ice cream late at night. Simply have less of it than if you were to just gorge. And so if you can be thoughtful about it, I think people should make it okay and feel okay about doing those things.
Yeah, everything in moderation. Mm-hmm. You touched on this earlier, but prioritizing sleep is really a big issue. It is always, especially now in the pandemic.
Absolutely. How often, even before this pandemic, did people prioritize 7 to 9 hours of restorative sleep? Very infrequently. In fact, many people wear their lack of sleep as a badge. And I feel like as a culture, we really need to move past that and recognize that we perform better and we're happier when we sleep well. And we know from our research that having poor sleep increases your risk of cognitive changes, potentially increases your risk of Alzheimer's disease specifically.
A lot of people are having trouble sleeping, though, during all of this, worrying about what's going on in the world.
Yes, and so that's what makes this pandemic even more difficult. And so I would encourage people to really stay away from some behaviors that they think could be helping their sleep. So too much alcohol. Alcohol actually disrupts our circadian rhythm and our sleep cycles. I would tend to stay away from sleep aids, these over-the-counter medications that we think can help us sleep, but actually are detrimental to our brain. Other things that, like exercise and eating the right foods, can be helpful to sleep. People who are busier during the day. And things like sleep hygiene are really important to address, and they're very readily available online as far as tips to help one fall asleep easier.
You are an expert on Alzheimer's disease, and you're going to be giving a statewide address talking about that and the pandemic. What are you going to be talking about?
Well, so I'm going to be providing a brief overview of COVID-19, as well as the conditions that put a person at risk of developing severe symptoms of COVID-19. These conditions are actually, they overlap greatly with the conditions that put us at risk for developing dementia. Mm. And so part of my talk is really showing that how we behave now, the decisions we make now, not only improve our well-being right now, but actually could lead to the prevention of dementia and could lead to more resilience to infections like COVID-19.
Interesting, you wouldn't necessarily put those two together.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and where can people see your talk?
The Alzheimer's Foundation of America, if they Google that or if they search for that online, they should find a link and they can register. It's for free. And there are other great speakers, and it's for 2.5 hours. And by being virtual, of course, you can tune in whenever you can.
All right, sounds very informative and important information.
And important for people battling Alzheimer's and their caregivers too.
Doctor, yeah. Thanks for being with us today.
It was great to see you, Dr. Chin. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you for having me.